Many incidents, humorous and otherwise, marked their progress. At Cabotville, Massachusetts, on going to bed one night, one of the company threw a lighted cigar stump into a box of sawdust, and the result was that an hour or two later, they all narrowly escaped suffocation from the smoke. At Lenox, Massachusetts, they spent Sunday, and Barnum went to church as usual. The sermon was directed against the circus, denouncing it in very abusive terms as an immoral and degrading institution. Thereupon, says Barnum, when the minister had read the closing hymn, I walked up to the pulpit stairs and handed him a written request, signed P.T. Barnum, connected with the circus, June 5, 1836, to be permitted to reply to him. He declined to notice it, and after the benediction, I lectured him for not giving me an opportunity to vindicate myself and those with whom I was connected. The affair created considerable excitement, and some of the members of the church apologized to me for their clergyman's ill behavior. A similar affair happened afterward at Port Deposit on the lower Susquehanna, and in this instance, I addressed the audience for half an hour, defending the circus company against the attacks of the clergyman. And the people listened, though their pastor repeatedly implored them to go home. Often have I collected our company on Sunday and read to them the Bible or a printed sermon, and one or more of the men frequently accompanied me to church. We make no pretense of religion, but we are not the worst people in the world, and we thought ourselves entitled to at least decent treatment when we went to hear the preaching of the gospel. Turner, the proprietor of the circus, was a self-made man. He had made himself rich through industry, as he believed any other man with common sense could do, and he was very proud of the fact.